Well, today I received a soft tick. Probably a fowl tick. If you look closely, you can see the bright yellow edges of the idiosoma, characteristic of this species. The author of the video asked if these parasites can live and reproduce in an apartment. And if they can't, how do they get into an apartment besides through a window? He found this tick on the ceiling, and before that he'd removed a smaller one from himself, probably a nymph. And naturally, he began to suspect that if the small offspring were in the apartment, it meant that parasites were also breeding here. But this is not true. These ticks don't live or reproduce in apartments permanently. They are parasites of birds, and they would only bite humans when extremely starving. And in such an extreme situation, they have no time to reproduce. The author writes that he began to notice them in the apartment closer to fall. So it's logical. Chicks fledged from pigeon or sparrow nests somewhere in the attic, ticks there lost their hosts, became hungry, and wandering through apartments in search of new sources of food. Both adult ticks and immature nymphs can crawl around in this way in search of food. How exactly they got there is a question specific to each individual apartment. Some enter through windows. By the way, they can squeeze through the gap between the window frame and the mosquito net frame. Some through ventilation, and some through cracks in the joints between pipes and ceilings or walls. The author of the video writes that the apartment is well maintained, but as we can see, the ticks don't seem to mind. And especially note how small and unnoticeable they are on the ceiling and walls. This is already the fifth specimen that the guy has discovered in the apartment. Not every person would even pay attention to such small fry on the wallpaper or under the baguette.